हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ रितेश कुमार राय फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच इलेक्ट्रिकल टेक्नोलॉजी एंड टुडे टॉपिक इज सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज ट्रांसफार्मर, व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर, व्हाट इज द कंस्ट्रक्शन and working principle of single phase transformer, and also discuss about why transformer cannot be used for the DC supply. Now in today lecture I will discuss about ideal characteristic of transformer. For a better understanding and easier explanation of a practical transformer, certain idealizing assumptions are made which are close approximations for a practical transformer. A transformer having these ideal properties, hypothetical, has no real existence and is referred to as the ideal transformer. It possesses certain essential features of a real transformer, but some detail of minor significance are ignored, which will be introduced step by step while analyzing a transformer. The idealizing assumption made as are follows. First of all, efficiency is 100%. Second much, no core loss. Third one is no copper loss, no leakage flux, no magnetizing current, and zero voltage regulation. No winding resistance, it means the primary and secondary winding have zero resistance. It means that there is no ohmic power loss and no resistive voltage drop in ideal transformer. Second, no magnetic leakage. It means there is no leakage flux and all the flux setup is confined to the core and both links the winding. No iron loss. It means hysteresis and eddy current losses in transformer core are zero. Or if no winding resistance, it means copper loss is zero and iron loss is zero. Obviously, the efficiency will be 100%. Zero magnetizing current. The core has infinite permeability and zero reluctance, so that zero magnetizing current is required for establishing the requisite amount of flux in the core. It means from above the discussion in ideal transformer is supposed to consist of two purely inductive coil bound on a loss free core. With the application of variable voltage on the primary, variable flux is set up in the primary winding. Due to this, variable flux and EMF even is set up in the primary, which oppose the applied voltage, counterbalancing it and saving it from excessive current and heating. This voltage is called back EMF. Now we discuss about ideal transformer on no load. No load means when the primary of a transformer is connected to the source of AC supply and the secondary is open, the transformer is said to be at no load. It means there is no load on secondary winding. Consider an ideal transformer whose secondary side is open and the primary winding is connected to a sinusoidal alternating voltage V1. The alternating applied voltage to the primary winding will cause flow of alternating current in the primary winding. Since the primary coil is purely inductive and there is no output secondary being open, the primary draw the magnetizing current IM only. The function of this current is merely to magnetize the core. If the transformer is true ideal, the magnetizing current should be zero by virtue of assumption. Since the reluctance of the magnetic circuit is never zero, it means IM has definite magnitude. The magnetizing current IM is small in magnitude and lags behind supply voltage given by 90 degree. The magnetizing current IM produces an alternating flux phi, which is at all times proportional to the current and hence in phase with the
voltage. We know that in ideal transformer, V1 I1 equal to V2 I2, it means the rating of primary winding is equal to the rating of secondary winding. Since no load, therefore secondary current I2 equal to 0, it means V2 into I2 equal to 0, it means V1 I1 equal to 0. Since V1 cannot be 0, thus I1 equal to 0. Practical transformer on no load. When a varying flux is set up in magnetic material, there will be power loss called the iron or core loss. So the input current to the primary under no load condition has also the supply the hysteresis and eddy current loss known as iron losses occurring in the core in addition to a small amount of copper loss occurring in primary winding. No copper loss occurring in secondary winding. Reason behind that, the secondary winding is open and no load connected to the secondary winding. Hence the no load primary current I0 does not lag behind applied voltage V1 by 90 degree but lags behind V1 by angle phi naught less than 90 degree. Input power on no load P0 equal to V1 I0 cos phi naught, where cos phi naught is the primary power factor under no load condition. It has also two components, in phase active or energy component known as IE, and another is I0 called the exciting current. And can be resolving this equation IE equal to I0 cos phi naught and IM equal to I0 sin phi naught. Squaring both the equation and adding them, then I0 equal to under root I square plus IM square and angle of phi naught equal to tan inverse IM upon I0. But in actual practice, a very small current ranging from 2 to 5% of full load voltage through the primary, even case of no load, it is called no load current. Practical transformer on full load. With the application of voltage at primary, full load current flow through it. Primary winding copper loss occurs, effect of which is similar to a resistor connected in series. Primary winding leakage flux occurs, the effect of which is similar to inductance. The core loss occurs in the iron core. Iron core gets magnetized. The primary winding is linked with variable flux and thus an EMF is induced in according to Faraday law of electromagnetic induction. The flux links with the secondary by low reluctance path provided by the iron core. EMF induced in secondary winding. Secondary winding leakage flux occurs. Secondary winding copper loss occurs. Output voltage across load is achieved. Then there are two type of losses. One is hysteresis loss and another is eddy current loss. Hysteresis loss is due to hysteresis curve in the iron core occurs in the core when a magnetic material is magnetized and magnetizing force is removed, it retains some magnetism called residual magnetism. This property is called retentivity. To demagnetize the material completely, the magnetic material is subjected to reverse magnetic field. The force required to demagnetize the material completely is called corrosive force. It means the transformer is a stating machine and therefore there is no friction or windage losses. The various power losses occurring in a transformer. One is iron or core losses. Iron loss is caused by the alternating flux in the core and consisting of hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. The core of transformer is subjected to an alternating magnetizing force and for each cycle of EMF in hysteresis loop is traced out. The hysteresis loss per second is given in the equation PH equal to eta dash B max k power x F V joule per second, where F is the supply frequency in hertz, B the volume of the core in cubic, eta dash is the hysteresis coefficient, B max is the peak value of the flux density in the core, X lies between 1.5 to 2.5 depending upon the material and often taken as 1.6. The above behavior of magnetic material is called hysteresis and loss associated is called hysteresis loss. Second one is eddy current loss. If the magnetic circuit is made up of iron,
And if the flux in the circuit is variable, current will be induced by induction in the iron circuit itself. All such current are known as eddy current. Eddy current result in a loss of power with consequent heating of the material. The eddy current loss is given by the equation P equal to KE d max square F square T square V watt or joule per second. From the above equation for eddy current loss in a thin sheet, it is obvious that eddy current loss vary at the square of maximum flux density. Maximum flux density, the square of the frequency, the square of the thickness of lamination. The hysteresis and eddy current loss depend upon the maximum flux density in the core and supply frequency. Since it has been determined that the mutual flux varies somewhat with the load, its variation being 1 to 3% from no load to full load, the core losses will vary somewhat with the load and its power factor. It may be emphasized here the core losses are assumed to remain constant from no load to full load. The variation in losses from no load to full load being very small and negligible, and the losses are determined from the open circuit and short circuit test. From open circuit test we can find iron loss, and for short circuit test we can find copper loss. And copper or ohmic loss, these losses occur due to ohmic resistance of the transformer winding. If I1 and I2 are the primary and secondary current respectively, and R1 and R2 are the respective resistance of the primary and secondary winding, then copper losses occurring in primary and secondary winding will be I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2 respectively. So the total copper losses will be I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. These losses vary at the square of the load current K or KVA. For example, if the copper losses at full load are PC, then copper losses at 1/2 or 1/3 of full load will be 1/2 whole square PC or 1/3 square PC. It means PC/4 or PC/9. Copper losses are determined on the basis of constant equivalent resistance R equivalent, determined from the short circuit test and then corrected to 75 degrees Celsius. Since the standard operating temperature of electrical machine, and we can minimize, how to minimize iron and copper loss. So we can minimize iron loss by using high grade steel, and we can minimize copper loss by using high grade steel. And we can minimize iron loss by using high grade steel. Thank you. Thank you very much.